Hello, everybody, and welcome to Untethered.tv. This is that place you come to find out what's going on in the mobile industry, to talk to the guys and the gals who are pioneers in the space, who are building the next generation companies as we are trying to figure out how to use this great medium called mobile. And I've got a great guest today. I believe in the future of shopping and the impact that mobile is going to have on shopping in general. The way we buy, what we buy, the price that we buy things for, the way we consume all this content, and also the fact that where we do it is no longer in the store. Where we do it is on our couch. Where we do it is on the park bench. Where we do it is in work. And I think that this is one of the key things. And why not take a company who has, 12 million products in their database? Is that right, Neel?
Yep, just over 12 million.
That is incredible. Just over 12 million. So this is Neel Grover, who is the president and CEO of a company called Buy.com. Neel, thank you so much for coming on and sharing the story to the Untether crowd, which there are many of them out there. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. It's great to be on. Thanks for having me.
I'll give you an opportunity here. Let's talk about Buy.com. What is Buy.com? For those people who have not heard of it, just talk about it, a little bit about its history, its genesis.
Sure. So we are a retail marketplace. Buy.com's been around since 1997, so quite a long time. Started off really known for selling computer products and electronics. And over the last 15 years, really expanded, created our marketplace about 5 years ago. So now we have over 5,000 great retailers from Toys R Us and Petco to Little Mom and Pops, selling to our 18 million plus customers. We really focus on just delivering a great customer experience. Companies transitioned to really bring a lot of the best merchants out there onto our platform. We were acquired about 2 years ago by Rakuten, the third largest e-commerce company in the world, which really focuses around empowering merchants and empowering commerce. And so what we do is we focus on our platform, focus on delivering a great customer experience, and seek out the best merchants, large and small, to help them bring their products to our end customers.
So it's really interesting that you talk about that, because the experience of buying something on a mobile device is drastically different than the experience of buying it on a, certainly in store, but also in on a website. Have you guys noticed, as you've transitioned into the mobile space, which you have quite effectively, have you noticed a difference in the way that people are buying? Any trends there?
Yeah, I mean, we see people, do a couple things differently. So one, we have different ways you can search on our mobile apps. You can search via taking a picture. You can take a picture of a product and it'll go through our database and try to match up that product. So if you're out for dinner and you love your bottle of wine and, you just want to see, because there's no barcode to scan on it, you don't want to, maybe you've had too much drink, you don't want to type it all in, you take a picture of the label. And quite likely it'll pull up in our catalog, and you can purchase that product right then. We of course have barcode scanning, so we do see that quite a bit. So there is a definite amount of showrooming going on, where consumers are going into stores, scanning a product in store, and pulling up the price on our site to see what that goes for. But they also pull up our reviews and our video content. To make sure that they're buying the best product, whether they're going to buy it in store or buy it on our site. We have quite a bit of video content on, and so you can quite easily get to our videos through the various search methods.
So how important is that when we talk about the impediments to purchasing, or the opportunities for a company like Buy.com to actually come in there, and because of its sophisticated database and the partners that you've got, and then the reviews that are part of that, it seems like an unfair advantage to a lot of companies that are out there that don't have this kind of digital expertise that you guys do have.
Well, I mean, so really going back to the fundamentals of what Buy.com and Rakuten really look at, it's empowering and partnering with retailers. And so whereas some of our competitors really look to use this as a competitive advantage to really hurt the brick and mortar retailers, we look at it as ways to partner with them. As I talked about, our core is empowering merchants. We want to get more and more retailers to come bring their products onto our platform. So whether you're a small retailer and you don't have the ability to create your own mobile site, we can build that for you. I mean, the great thing is, being part of Rakuten, the third largest e-commerce company in the world, we have a lot of resources whereby we're building these great platforms. As being a smaller merchant, you can bring your products on our platform, customer comes into your store, looks for that product, you know, they can purchase it right from us right there, you know, and get that, you get that ability to showcase your products to other consumers. With regards to in-store, yeah, I mean, you do see some customers, you know, they want lower prices. And you're seeing that, you know, the advent of the mobile technologies are really pushing prices down. I think brick-and-mortar retailers have to be a little more competitive in-store. You know, they've got huge advantages over online-only retailers with their physical presence. You know, having that immediacy, you know, ability to pick up that product right there and then it's powerful. And so what we try to do is just deliver the best experience we can without having that piece. Price is definitely a part of what we do, but we also focus on creating terrific content. And that was really important, that our mobile apps and our mobile sites don't just focus on here's the lowest price, but it also delivers the rich content to them. We've had a TV show called My TV now for about 6 years, and you can watch any of those episodes on the product pages of the products, you know, on our mobile site, or you can go to the section in our apps that are just by TV and watch the videos. So even if you do want to buy that product in store, but you're not sure because a salesperson may or may not know if it's the best product for you, you can actually come to our site, watch the video on it, read other customer reviews on it, see what else we're recommending, and still buy it in store. There's no guarantee that they're going to buy it from us.
I really like the fact that you brought this mobile television into market, and I think it's a great concept, because, you know, for product reviews and such. But, you know, when you touched on customer service, it's so right, because you know, usually there's a human interaction. There's an element of human interaction when you walk into a store and you're greeted, and you have a high likelihood of finding something that you're looking for inside of a store. But I mean, there must be some kind of a trick, but there's got to be some way that you can simulate that in a mobile environment. You know, it's one thing to find the best price, but I think that's the motivator. But ultimately, people shop with you on all platforms simply because you guys have something that other digital retailers don't, or other e-tailers don't. Is there anything that you feel that you guys do better than everybody else?
Well, I mean, I think that a couple of things, I mean, that we focus on providing, you know, in delivering the best experience. It's having the deepest catalog possible. So we have over 12 million unique products. We have multiple sellers on many of those products. So if for some reason somebody's out of stock on that product, or you can see multiple price points or geographies. So you'll see certain retailers in our marketplace that are, you know, in a location closer to you that can get that to you next day for much lower than, say, you know, another national internet retailer may, or maybe a lot more convenient or easier than going to your brick and mortar store. We do focus on delivering the best search experience as well. So we have, you know, normal type in text search. We have the barcode scanning, which definitely, you know, we see a lot more of that now that consumers are taking the apps in store. We have picture search, as I mentioned, and we also have voice search. So we try to make it as simple as possible and continue to refine those areas to make sure that we can help the customer find what they're really looking for. Then when they do the search, you know, we try to, you know, make sure that they can, you know, find exactly what they're looking for, even if the proper product shows up, but we can show them other recommendations of things that consumers have purchased or have looked at while looking at that same product. So, although we don't have that in-store touch point, which definitely is, you know, key, and it's nice to have, we've tried to deliver that through our, you know, millions of customers and history, really trying to lead the customer down the road to what we think that they do want to buy. Now, on our classic site, we allow you to chat with your friends and have real-time conversations with our store owners and our customer service, and you can have that interaction. We haven't yet brought that to the mobile, though we are looking at ways to bring that.
I love that, your classic site. That's hysterical. You know, not so long ago that was at the forefront of technology. Now it is mobile. I'm very interested in your perspective of the impact that mobile is going to have on the things like pricing, the things like, you know, customer expectation. You know, how is what you guys are doing changing the way that people buy and the prices that they pay? It must be pretty staggering to watch this happen.
You know, I think the brick and mortar retailers probably see it a little bit more, right? Because we focus on always having low prices. So we haven't had to lower our prices because of mobile. Mobile has just further extenuated, you know, consumers finding out about our lower prices. And so it's it's definitely been a benefit for us, and we believe that's going to just continue to go, you know, the right way for us, thankfully. But that's something that we've always focused on, is having and delivering great low prices to our consumers. I think that, you know, like I said, I think consumers are noticing that more and more. You do see, you know, we have a lot of great promotions, and obviously there are a lot of great flash sale sites out there. So when we have the hot promotions, mobile and having the mobile apps and the mobile sites allow consumers to take advantage of those on the go. I mean, unfortunately, I know people that are driving and buying deals from us at the same time.
Don't tell me that.
I do not advise anyone to do that, please. But people, you know, it's that quick and easy that you can literally get an email from us with our, you know, our 50 hottest deals that day. You can click on it, and within a couple clicks, you know, on your mobile phone, you've made the purchase. You've got all your payment information kept there. You know, you get your reward loyalty points. You can use your loyalty points. You can log in all very, very simply on your mobile phone.
So what about you know, I can see that normal, you know, brick and mortar retailers are looking at this thinking this is a threat, and I, you know, something like what you guys bring, which is, you know, a showroom and a tablet, a showroom and on a smartphone, they would look at this and say, oh, you know, there's downward pressure on pricing, the new MSRP has dropped considerably as a result of this. Because you can walk up and quite literally scan any product and find a better product or better price. And then if they have any sense, they match it, but then they lose their margin. You know, how is, you got to let us in on how this is shifting the industry. Because I think companies like yours, like buy.com, become very disruptive to the norm. And especially when you attach, you know, somebody's mobile device, which we're attached to the hip, what does that do to this industry? Is it strengthening the industry, or is it just eliminating friction or excess in the industry itself, in the retail space?
You know, it's probably doing a little bit of both, but we like to think of it more of the latter, that it is getting rid of some of the excess in the industry. You know, like I said, some of our competitors are actually incentivizing consumers to go into brick and mortar stores and use their apps and, you know, for a heavy discount. Now, we've had various promotions where we want people to use our apps and get used to it. But we really try to partner with the brick and mortar retailers. And so, you know, we're trying to find ways to work with them and not marginalize what they're providing, because we think there's a great partnership between buy.com and a brick and mortar retailer. But there are, you know, in some cases there are higher margins in store. And, you know, to the extent that you can get that online, I think what we do is we help with the efficiencies in the system. And ultimately, you know, you want the customer to be happy and feel good about their purchase. And so if whatever store it may be, whether they're buying it in store or they're buying it online with us or somebody else, you want the customer to feel good about that purchase. And, you know, we believe with our pricing, the way we do our pricing, with our content, our reviews, our videos, you know, our 45-day return policy on millions of products, that consumers are going to feel really good about buying from us. If they happen to go look at a product somewhere else, you know, they can easily find what the price is from us and get it in a couple days. If they want it right there, they at the same time can use our app and our mobile sites to see the video content and the reviews and decide to still buy it right there and then, and we probably help the conversion of that sale. So I think we're actually a good partner for brick and mortar retailers, you know, and I think we just help bring more efficiencies in the market.
Yeah, I mean, I've done that, you know, even with your product, is that I have, you know, solidified a purchase decision based on a review. So, you know, I thank you very much for that as well. It's probably not, I mean, it's enabling the industry. But what about, you've got to think a little bit forward here, that the impact of what you guys are doing is quite substantial. Is what are the risks for you guys? You know, why does a company that you guys help, why would they come to you and put their catalog in your catalog so that they can sell their product through you guys? What's the benefit to them?
Well, I mean, the benefit really is we're going to bring them an incremental customer. Now, you know, every retailer out there has their own following, and depending on how much they put into their own budget and marketing, you know, whether they're the largest of brick and mortar stores or just a little mom and pop out of a garage that has a great product, you know, we want to be an enabler. And so the one big thing that we do, or really what we don't do, that our larger competitor in Seattle does, is, you know, we won't buy product to compete with our sellers. And so a merchant has a great product, they've got a great price on it. We're not going to go try to get that at a lower, you know, to sell that at a lower price to compete with them. We want to enable them, empower them, and work with them. And so you'll see that we're a great partner in that regards, and we really want to empower small business and large business throughout the United States. And we can bring them an incremental customer. It's a different avenue for their marketing. We actually allow our merchants to email our customers through our platform. We give them all the tools to email, and we actually create a storefront for them. So whether you have your own storefront or you don't and you need one, we'll build that for you here or help you build it here at buy.com. You get a mobile storefront with that as well. So you build a nice storefront out. It can be your home away from home, or it could be your only store. But you know, once again, you come to the mobile site and you'll have a nice mobile storefront built out, and you wouldn't have had to go through any of the heavy infrastructure costs to get that.
All right. What's so exciting about this for you guys? I know that buy.com, you've been around, you've been a part of buy.com since 2003. So back before really mobile as we know it, before that day that the iPhone was released in 2007, before we really started looking at smartphones deeply. So you've gone through all of these transitions, but what is it that gets you so excited about, that keeps you up at night around what mobile it means to buy.com?
Well, I mean, we're always trying to figure out, what the consumer wants before the consumer wants it. So how we can make it that much easier for them to find the product they want, the products that they are not sure that they wanted, but actually are really happy that they do find and do want, and how can we get it to them in the exact time and location where they're at? And so, working on geolocating and time-based promotions, are really important. Working with brick-and-mortar retailers for that same thing, to bring our marketplace, from our classic site to the mobile to the storefront is really exciting for us. So it's something that we're working on with some of our larger brick and mortar retailers now to really bring our platform in store with them, but still within the buy.com mobile apps.
So do you think that's really where we're going here in the next couple of years is, there's a lot of conversation right now about the transaction piece of this, the e-wallets and the mobile wallets and NFC and how all of this plays out. And certainly a battle's going on with, ISIS and Google Wallet and everybody's trying to catch Square for transactions, all that kind of stuff. But do you think that from a retail perspective, where should retailers be focusing right now? Is it on, it's not on the transaction side, but it really is about product research and information? Is it about actually selling? Where should they be focusing right these days?
Yeah, I mean, it depends on their cost structure. I think first and foremost, though, content and, reviews, anything to help the customer is going to be really important. I mean, I think at some point, customers are going to get to a point where they feel that they did all the research, the brick-and-mortar retailer or whomever it is, helped them with the purchase. They do feel good about making the purchase there. Now there's definitely going to be a set of customers that are ultimately going to always want to buy from the lowest price, lowest place that they feel confident with. But I think that, the brick and mortar retailers need to focus on their strengths, and their strengths are obviously locations and content. And, they need to bring them all together to the consumer in an easy, package for the consumer to find it. I mean, I think a lot of them are doing a terrific job. When our entire business is online and mobile, being part of that and extension of that, it's our sole focus. And I think you're seeing really every large brick and mortar retailer double down, triple down their efforts on mobile and on the internet. And so I think, that's where we can help some of the smaller ones that don't have the same capabilities. But I think you'll see both the large and the small really, continue to focus on delivering a great experience on mobile as if it's, separate and distinct, but also tied into the storefront.
I mean, you brought up a great point there, which is around the bricks and mortar companies, the companies that are traditional retailers, trying to get into this space, which is the mobile space, and trying, doubling down, as you said, and catching up. Do you think you have an advantage over these guys because of what your origin has always been in the digital world? Or is it, and can they can leverage your competency to be able to bring their company up very quickly, can't they?
It depends on the size again. I mean, I think there's some fantastic companies out there that have great technology and are doing a really good job and are ahead of the curve for sure. And then there are others that don't have the same resources or have not focused on this and you know, have had their own issues with just retail. You know, it's a challenging environment for everybody today. So any incremental, you know, partnership we believe is important. We believe we're a great partner in that sense, that we don't compete with them, that we want to really help them and grow. And you know, we bring some different pieces that some of our competitors don't. So we definitely feel that, you know, that they should work with us. But like I said, some of them have been doing a terrific job already.
All right, I got one more question just around the competitor in Seattle. And it's around the hardware-software combination that you start to see here, which is, you know, a tablet as the storefront, and then, you know, that application layer that you guys have. Do you look at playing in that space? Do you look at building some hardware out so that you can enable the same way that the other guys are thinking of doing this, that has maybe not become their competitive advantage, but really has driven home the whole retail piece of the tablet world?
Yeah, no, they've done a terrific job. I've got all the respect for them. They've done a great job in that. I think we treat our merchants a little better and different. But we actually have played in the space. So we're really going big in this space. Our parent company, Rakuten, a few months ago bought Kobo. So Kobo is the third largest ebook company in the U.S. and quite large internationally. And in certain countries are the largest ebook provider. So you'll definitely see a lot more of Kobo with Rakuten and Buy.com in the future. So we're definitely very excited about that purchase.
Yes, and I mean, I'm up in Canada, so we know Kobo very well because of Chapters and Indigo. You know, that was the ebook platform for them. And certainly, as those stores have migrated into more than a bookstore and more of a lifestyle store, shall we say, you know, Kobo, I could see playing a great combination. And I knew that, obviously, that you guys had the same parent company had bought them. So that combination becomes pretty powerful, doesn't it? Is that not the future here, where you're looking at that tablet, that, you know, 12 million products, the window in? That's obviously what you're banking on, that combination.
That's definitely a big part of it. You know, I think there's a lot of different pieces, but Kobo is definitely an important part of our overall environment going forward.
Well, that's something that I can't wait for. I mean, you know, certainly the ease with which I can shop from my couch would make me a very happy guy. I'm pretty sure I speak for many, many men out there about they're loath to go into a shopping center. I'd like to get that same quality product, but I would love to do it just so that with ease of use, just the same way that I buy an app, right, for my kids to play on, which is key, I think, isn't it? That simplicity.
Sure. Okay. Yep, absolutely.
All right, so, you know, where can people find information about you guys?
www.buy.com.
That's it. That's easy.
That's it. It's simple. Buy.com.
I have on the screen right now, you obviously have a buy.com iPhone app, an Android app, and a BlackBerry app, as well as you've got an iPad app that's coming soon. Is there a time frame for that?
We do. It'll be in Q2. You know, we're trying to just bring a next level of you know, to the apps, and we think the iPad really allows that, and so it'll be a really rich rich and fun and entertaining shopping experience.
Can I ask that maybe we could connect after you've launched that to walk through the features of this thing, so that you know, and bring it to my audience, because I think that this is something that they'd be very interested in understanding, you know, the thought process going through it and building that application.
Absolutely. Would love
to. Great. Neel, I appreciate your time. I know it's been very short, but I really appreciate the fact that you've taken the time to come out here and talk about what you guys are doing at Buy.com. I follow you guys. I will continue to follow you guys, and I hope to have you on when the iPad app is launched again. Thank you so much.
Great. Nice talking to you.
We've been speaking with Neel Grover, who is the president and CEO of Buy.com. Go to Buy.com if you're interested, certainly in understanding who they are. Check out the various app stores, app world, and the marketplace for their mobile applications, and start, you know, using this. It's an incredible database, and they also have daily deals on there, which is something we didn't touch on. So, you know, take a look around and start using Buy.com. Really appreciate it. Neel, thank you so much for your time. Folks out there,
thank you.
Really appreciate you watching, listening, wherever you may be. Thank you for bringing this into your day. We'll see you next time on untether.com. Thanks, Neel.
All right.